Hello and welcome to my channel. This is part 2 of how to crop photos to shapes using Illustrator. And today I'm going to show something like how to crop this photo, for example. So to begin, let's go to Illustrator file, new. And I'm just going to take this is the YouTube thumbnail specification, so I'm just gonna take that and click OK. So to begin with, we need our image in Illustrator. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna head over to my folder. It doesn't matter if you're on Windows or Mac, all you have to do is open your folder, select the photo that you want and click and drag. So this is how you get your photo. Now click and drag to arrange it to however you want it. So I'm just going to keep it like this. This is, by the way, a photo taken in Buffalo last year where it was snowing. Like, we had some winter storm, and this is my brother. That was his first snow ever. So he was so excited about it that he wanted to go out and stand in that snowfall. Now I'm going to go head over to the shape tool. You can select the rounded rectangle tool, or if you want something else, just right click on it and then you get different shapes right here. So I'm going to go ahead and take the polygonal tool, click and drag. So as you can see, this pulls out with the center, so you can't place it where you want it. So after you have done finished drawing, just head over to select tool. Click on the center. It's much easier if you hold the center. It's not necessary that you have to hold it. Go and place it. But you see, it's not aligned to the ends. So I'm just going to hold here. You see, when you do this, your arrow changes to this one. This means that you can turn it. Turn it till you feel it's all right. I think this should be fine. Once I do that, I have to select both the image and the shape. So I select the shape first, then I hold the shift key down and select the image. This way, when you hold shift key down, you can select multiple objects. Now I'm going to hit right click, make clipping mask. So yeah, that's, you have your photo in a very nice crop position right now. But there's one point that you need to know. The rest of the photo is still on the canvas. So if you try to export it in, even in PNG, the rest of the space comes out as white space. So it's like it really takes up the amount of space that photo would take. So you want to cut off that residue which you have on the sides right here. To do that, you have to follow certain steps. So once you have your mainly clipping mask, go to your transparency panel. If you don't have it right here, what you can do is you can go to window and hit on transparency. So once you have that, it's usually normal, make it as darken. Next, you go to object, click on flatten transparency. Just hit OK, don't bother with anything here. It might take some time to run it, depending on the size of your image probably, but most of the time it runs pretty quick. But if it's a little slow, don't bother, your image is too huge, that's all. Next, go to object and then click on expand. So now what you have is just the cropped image. You don't have anything else. So now what you're going to do is you're going to export this. So you go to File, Export, Export As. You have to save this as a PNG, otherwise it won't make any sense. So I'm just going to say Test and hit Export. And you can change your resolution, etc. if you want right here. I'm just going to keep it at 150 and OK. This usually takes some time, probably because it's huge. There's lots of processing going on. I'm sorry about my tone, because I have a really bad cold and I know I sound terrible, but so you then go to your folder, it's OneDrive. This is the test PNG that I have. You double click on it, and there you go. You have your image. So this shape which I showed you is like which was something already there in Illustrator, but you can hand draw your shapes like probably using. I'm just gonna uncheck, undo everything and show you something with shapes. So if you take a paintbrush and I say I want something like, don't mind my drawing because I'm not too good at it freehand. Okay, so I'm just gonna click on it and give it a fill color because that's really important. Okay, so now I'm gonna hold the shift key and select both of these and right click and say make clipping mask. So there you go. You have your image. I mean, you have to follow the same steps which you did after making the clipping mask. So yeah, that is how you crop a photo or fill shape with a photo in Illustrator. Pretty easy, isn't it? See you next week.